Hello, everyone. Thanks so much for logging on to CBSN Denver. Time for your CBSN Denver Daily Sports Line, brought to you by BetMGM, the king of sportsbooks. A ho-hum day yesterday. Finished 1-1. Didn't get the Lou Dort over prop. He missed about 18 layups that he probably should have hit yesterday, so that didn't cash for us. We did get the over in Game 2 between the Giants and the Rockies. What an incredible game that was. Charlie Blackmon with a walk-off three-run homer as the Rockies come back from down 6-2 in the ninth to get the win there. I want to bring in BetMGM's Jason Scott joining us today. And Jason, as you know, you're down in Australia, but I can imagine you know it was quite the Aaron Rodgers frenzy here on Thursday and really throughout the weekend. And the betting markets had a really, really interesting shift in them in terms of the Broncos. What did we see happen when all the Aaron Rodgers drama started?
Look, we saw the Broncos backed in every market they were available in. People wanted to back them to win the division, the conference, and of course the championship. Look, the word on the street is it's still a fair chance of happening. So, in the division, the Packers are minus 125. I'm not sure Jordan Love can't win that division. Certainly in their division, but Broncos have been very well backed. They're in the clear second favorite in the division behind KC.
Hey, Jason, from a bookmaker's perspective, when something like that happens and that news comes out on Thursday, what happens for you guys in terms of how you adjust the lines and then how much money do you start to see coming in on the Broncos? People taking a shot that maybe that news is going to come to fruition, and obviously that boosts their odds.
Yeah, that's exactly what happens. It's a lot of speculative behavior that it will happen and we take all markets. Now, if it comes to fruition, and what we saw with Brady last year, the moment he signed for the Bucks, and then we saw a second wave of money when Gronk came, that people are just willing to take every price, and the Bucks were the worst price, were the worst result in our book for the whole season last year, and I suspect we'll see exactly the same, which with whatever team Rodgers turns up at.
Yeah, if that does happen, it's going to happen after June 2nd due to some financials there in the NFL. Jason, we got a couple games to talk about tonight. The Nuggets at home against the New York Knicks. A Knicks team, by the way, that has covered the spread in 15 of their last 16 games. Denver comes into this game as a 4-point favorite. The over-under is at 215.5. When you look at this game, Jason, what, if anything, stands out to you?
Well, Michael, you and I have been doing this show, and I think for the last 6 weeks, I've said I want to be on the Nuggets, and they've won either on a Wednesday or a Thursday, depending on what day we filmed. I can't believe the price of the Knicks.
Yeah.
To be honest, I think they've won, as well as the covering the spread, they're winning games, they won 12 of 30. I think it's plus 4 all day.
I'm kind of tempted to go with you here, and I don't necessarily like going against the Nuggets, but when I look at this Nuggets team, P.J. Dozier now on the injured list, Monte Morris out, Will Barton continues to be out, and the Knicks are playing really, really good basketball. It's been a really fun year for Knicks fans. I'm with you here. I think I'm going to take Knicks plus 4 in this one, and maybe the Nuggets still get a win and squeak one out. I think it's going to be a really close game, and Jason, I think this has a tendency, it could be a real slugfest. We kind of saw, I felt like basketball got set back at least 15 years in that game between the Lakers and the Nuggets the other night out in LA. I mean, that was just brutal from an offensive perspective. But you're looking at another game that could go that way because you've got two of the top 8 defensive teams in the NBA tonight, the Nuggets at number 8 and the Knicks number 1 in terms of points allowed per game.
Yeah, look, I think your man Michael Parker Jr. could be the difference here if the Nuggets are to win. He was shooting at 50% from 3 post Murray's injury until that debacle that you mentioned the other night at the Lakers where he struggled. For them to win, he's going to have to hit those shots.
Yeah, he looked disengaged in part of that game. I'm going to be interested to see how he comes out tonight, especially the early part of that game. He's just kind of standing around, not really doing much of anything, and I was on the over points, rebounds, and assists, and that didn't cash. I'm also on the Nikola Jokic over tonight. I think that has a good shot at getting hit. It's 24.5. It's hit in 3 of the last 4 games. Somebody's going to have to score for the Nuggets. I think it could be MPJ or could be Jokic, but Jokic has obviously been the guy. So give me the Jokic over 24.5 is one of my best bets for tonight. Jason, is you take a look at the rest of the NBA slate, I'm going to call you crazy for this one, but I know you like the Portland Trailblazers tonight.
Yeah, it's the time of the year where we've got to look at the standings as much as the matchups. They need to keep winning. Before they lost to the Hawks the other night, they'd won their previous 4 games by an average of 17. Okay, a couple of the sides might have had injuries when they played them, but it was the Celtics, the Nets, the Grizzlies, and the Pacers They're all much better than the Cavaliers, whose scoring's been anemic lately. I just think the good players are playing well for the Blazers. I'm happy to take the minus 12, which is very unusual for me. But yeah, all the stars are aligned tonight.
I remember one thing you told me during football season was that you're allergic to double-digit spreads, especially in the NFL. But hopefully the allergy doesn't come back to bite you in the NBA tonight. So there's a look at your CBSN Denver Daily Sports Line for Wednesday. We've got the Nuggets and the Knicks tonight at Ball Arena. Knicks plus 4 in that one. I wouldn't hate it if you took the under either as well. Give me the Nikola Jokic over 24.5. And then Jason likes the Blazers minus 12 against the Cavs tonight. All right, that's going to do it for us. Thanks so much, as always, for logging on to CBSN Denver for your CBSN Denver Daily Sports Line, brought to you by BetMGM, the king of sportsbooks.